It's in the name, Dazzle Dry, but they do dry dazzlingly fast. Hi, I'm Cassie, and I am over the moon excited today to tell you about one of my personal favorite safer home polish systems. It's called Dazzle Dry. Let's get into it. Dazzle Dry. A little bit about it. It is one of the few 10-free, there's a bunch of different certifications, 10-free, 7-free, 3-free out there of safer markers. And what that means is that it's free of the 10 most common toxic chemical aggravators that are found in common polish systems. I'm gonna share some of my top tips for using Dazzle Dry, and I have a few, and they make a difference. So if you really want to get more mileage, more days out of your manicure, don't skip these steps. It'll make a big difference. Do you need the whole system, right? And the answer is yes, you do. So you'll see that these have numbers. There's number one step on this nail prep, this nail primer. It's a liquid that you put on. This is different from a polish remover. Step two is a base coat. Step three is going to be your color. And step four is going to be your top coat. I get reliably at least a full week with a lot of heavy use. I'm washing dishes, I'm chasing babies. These nails don't have an easy go of it, and they still look pretty good. And they're so quick to change out. And one of the things I love about it is literally how fast they dry. So it's in the name, Dazzle Dry, but they do dry dazzlingly fast. And that's another reason why I love them is I can paint my nails 30 minutes before I go to bed and not wake up with imprints of my sheets. After you've got your nails cleaned, then I recommend buffing them. I have spent a long time polishing my nails without buffing them, and I found that the polish just tends to lift a little bit sooner when I go that route. This way, it stays put for a really long time. Next tip that I have for you, and some of these tips are a blend. They come from Dazzle Dry themselves. But is to heat up your base coat. Okay, so when your base coat comes in, it's going to be, if depending on the temperature outside, going to be milky white and thick. Okay, so you actually have to warm it up in order to use it, in order to make it look nice and liquidy like this. There's this optional little thing that you can get from Dazzle Dry called a ridge filler. I've done these polishes, these manicures with and without the ridge filler, and I'm team ridge filler. If you like a gel manicure, if you like how thick and just kind of how smooth it makes your manicure, you're going to love the ridge filler. It really helps provide that extra volume and thickness, but not in a too thick. It's not too thick. Am I making sense? My last tip for you of getting the most mileage out of your Dazzle Dry manicure is the order might seem a little excessive. Number one, nail primer, and then once your nails are all clean, and if you have any color left on your nails from a prior manicure, this nail primer will actually do a really good job of taking it off. So nail primer, and then don't touch anything after you do that, right? So try not to go make dinner in between steps one and two, because you're gonna put more stuff on your nail. The point is that they're really, really clean from this. Step two, the base coat. It's already thin and warmed through. Step three is going to be your ridge filler. Okay, and then we're gonna do another base coat. Okay, and then two coats of color, whatever color you want. This color is called Love. And then the final step is going to be number four, the top coat. And I usually, it dries so fast, y'all, that by the time, and I polish my nails pretty quickly, but by the time I'm done painting the 10th nail, the first nail that I started on is dry enough for me to start on the next coat. It really dries incredibly fast. And then I give myself 5 minutes after I'm totally done to make sure that it's all set, but it is like done, really nice and set. The last tip I have for you, and this is just a generalized manicure tip that I've learned over the last years of painting my own nails, is that for the best results, try not to paint all the way to the edge of your cuticle and all the way to the side of your nail. If you leave just a little bit of space, you're actually gonna find that you're gonna have a nicer looking polish, and it won't, you know, sometimes when I was painting my nails from home, if I would go all the way to the edge of the nail because I wanted to get the most mileage out of my nail polish, it just looked really rough around the edges and not very trim and polished, for lack of a better word. It just didn't look very polished. And so if you leave a little bit of an area around your nail, you're gonna have a really nice professional looking manicure. I hope you found that helpful. For more on Dazzle Dry and also the other safer nail polishes that I have reviewed, be sure to check out the links below. They're all over on fedandfit.com.